Greetings. Thank you for your civil post, brother. There are too many points to address in one YouTube message. Here's some facts. Why is it that the Old Testament didn't mention any Son of God nowhere, or even mention Jesus until Paul come alone? This is only your first point, brother, and I will try diligently to answer this in only one video. But that may be impossible. There is so much about the Son of God in the Bible. Let me give you a topic list and support each point as I go. 1. Prophet David revealed the Son of God. Psalm 2:7. I will declare the decree the Lord has said to me, Thou art my Son, this day have I begotten thee. This is a prophecy of the Son of God who would come in the future. That is the nature and purpose of prophecy, to reveal knowledge of the future men cannot naturally know. Those who disbelieve wrongly claim this speaks of David as the Son of God. But David, as a prophet, would often give messages that were not about himself. This is absolutely the case in Psalms 2:7. But even claiming David is the Son of God is a problem for those who disbelieve, as it still means God has a son. Psalm 2:12, Kiss the Son, lest he be angry, and you perish from the way, when his wrath is kindled but a little. Blessed are all they that put their trust in him. David confirmed he was not speaking of himself and repeated his reference to the Son of God. Blessed are they that put their trust in the Son of God. This cannot be speaking of a man, including David. 2. Prophet Solomon revealed the Son of God. Proverbs 34. Who has ascended into heaven and descended? Who has gathered the wind in his fists? Who has wrapped the waters in his garment? Who has established the ends of the earth? What is his name? Or his son's name? Surely you know. And Islam is blind and ignores the message of Prophet Solomon. 3. Prophet Isaiah revealed the Son of God. Isaiah 7:14. Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Immanuel. The son born to the virgin will be called God with us. It does not mean figuratively God supports us, like he's on our side. Isaiah 9:6, For a child will be born to us, a son will be given to us, and the government will rest on his shoulders, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace. The son will be called Mighty God. The Son will be called Eternal Father. The God of the prophets has revealed himself this way, brother. So three prophets of Yahweh God revealed the Son of God. God has revealed himself by the prophets. Either you believe the prophets or you are an unbeliever. But clearly the Old Testament teaches God has a son. Why is it that the Old Testament didn't mention any Son of God nowhere? Clearly the Old Testament teaches God has a son. And Islam is blind and ignores the message of the prophets of Yahweh God. Point 4. The high priest knew the Messiah would be the Son of God. Matthew 26:63. But Jesus remained silent. Then the high priest said to him, I demand in the name of the living God, tell us if you are the Messiah, the Son of God. The high priest knew the message of the prophets, and Islam is blind and ignores the knowledge of the high priest of Israel. 5. The disciples of Jesus, the Messiah, called him the Son of God. Matthew 16:16, Simon Peter answered, You are the Christ, the Son of the living God. So Peter said this to Jesus, brother. And Jesus had the chance to respond to Peter. Jesus could have said, Allah has no son, Allah needs no son. But Jesus did not say this, and we have a record of what Jesus said. And Jesus answering said to him, Blessed are you, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood did not reveal it to you, but my Father in the heavens. Knowing that Jesus is the Son of God is a revelation from God. And Islam is blind and ignores these teachings of Jesus the Messiah. 5. Demons cast out by Jesus knew he was the Son of God. Mark 5:7, and crying out with a loud voice, he said, What have you to do with me, Jesus, Son of the Most High God? I adjure you by God, do not torment me. Matthew 8:29, and behold, they cried out, What have you to do with us, O Son of God? Have you come here to torment us before the time? Demons know who God is, brother. Still they rebel against God. And demons know God has a son, brother, because the Son of God has authority over them. If God had no son, no demon would cry out to the Son of God to leave them alone. And Islam is blind and ignores these events in the life of Jesus the Messiah. 6. Satan knew he, Jesus, was the Son of God. Matthew 4:3, the tempter came to him and said, If you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become bread. The only way this taunt and temptation makes any sense is if God has a son and every spiritual being in the universe knows it, and 2, Satan has an expectation that God's son would come to the earth. However, the entire challenge is stupid if Jesus was not the Son of God. And if Jesus followed Mohammedism, Jesus would just say, No, I am not the Son of Allah. Allah has no son. Jesus did not say that either, proving Jesus is not a Mohammedan. And Islam is blind and ignores the understanding of this event in the life of Jesus the Messiah. 7. Jesus himself said he was the Son of God. John 10:36. Do you say of him whom the Father sanctified and sent into the world, You are blaspheming, because I said I am the Son of God? So Jesus himself said he was the Son of God. Pure and simple, black and white text. And Islam ignores what Jesus said, even while Islam claims it respects Jesus as a prophet. Point 8. Even a Roman centurion could see Jesus was the Son of God. Mark 15:39, and when the centurion who stood facing him saw that in this way he breathed his last, he said, Truly this man was the Son of God. The Roman centurion had seen death and seen the way men face death. And this Roman, who was not a Jewish believer, saw a difference in the way Jesus faced death. To the extent that the Roman said Jesus was the Son of God, a God the Roman did not even worship. And Islam ignores the testimony and opinion of someone with some authority to speak to death. Why is it that the Old Testament didn't mention any Son of God nowhere, or even mention Jesus until Paul came along? I think you meant came along. I showed you 8 different facts, brother, and clearly Islam has lied to you if it told you there was no mention of the Son of God. 2, all the proofs are from before Paul was even called as an apostle of the Son of God. In reality, Jesus being the Son of God was proven long before Jesus called Paul as his servant. Jesus was proven to be the Son of God when Jesus was resurrected from the dead. Romans 1:4, and declared to be the Son of God with power, according to the Spirit of holiness, by the resurrection from the dead. The Comforter, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God, the Spirit of truth, proved Jesus was the Son of God. by Jesus' resurrection from the dead. And that is why Satan's most desperate and all-encompassing scheme must deny that Jesus was resurrected. Jesus was already proven to be the Son of God by the resurrection. And I have no doubt you are sincere in your commitment to Muhammad. But Muhammad is a liar, and the Word of God proves Muhammad is a liar. Jesus is the Son of God. The challenge for you, brother, is whether you are offended when I say Muhammad is a liar, or you are a man who respects God and the truth. If you regard truth, you will be angry at Muhammad the liar. Muhammad lied to his men to make them slaves to fight in Muhammad's wars. And Muhammad lies to you from his grave, dragging you to hell as you submit to Muhammad. Time is short, brother. Do you have any regard for God, for his prophets, for the truth? Either you have eyes to see and ears to hear and a heart that desires truth, or your real Allah is Muhammad. If you value Muhammad over God, the prophets, and the truth, you are a Muhammadan. And Muhammad's religion damns you to ignore the prophets. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.